Okay, this is Muichimotsu doing my second part of my Dragon Ball thoughts. This is a request from Guitar Hero 3 Players 986, which I think I will just call Guitar Hero 986 for simplicity's sake. The name is unfortunately a little long, and I don't want to have to waste time, or your time, waste my time or your time saying the name, and instead I could be talking about whatever I was going to talk about. In this case, I was requested, or suggested anyway, I might as well treat as a request, be happy. I'm actually taking the time out of my somewhat busy schedule to actually do this. But anyway, on to Dragon Ball Z, which I was already alluding to in the last one. But this was the series I grew up on. I liked it. I probably still would like it if I went back to it, especially everything after Garlic Jr. Maybe even if I really watched the Frieza Saga and the Namek Sagas, I'd enjoy those too. But then again, it really could be said to go downhill somewhat with how the Android Saga went. It was very intimidating in the beginning, and you would have thought, hey, they get to fight androids, but they're incredibly powerful, so they have to do some sort of special training or learn something special, but then they just fight the androids and beat them, right? No. They bring in this other plot device that is this crazy melding of everyone's powers, and then he kicks ass. Even more ass, unfortunately. But the plot devices became one of the things that makes it notorious even to this day. I mean, from the beginning, we have, oh no, Goku's an alien. Okay. And then we have this little indication that Gohan's gonna be really powerful. His half-Saiyan son and all that. What else? We have, going to space. Well, actually, no. Goku dies, unfortunately. Yeah. It does make a nice little twist in the beginning of the series when your main character that you loved in the original Dragon Ball series dies in the first episode. But it's alright. Because he goes on Snake Way, Probably one of the few interesting parts about Dragon Ball Z is always those nice little transitions to Otherworld, as it was called. Although it might as well be called Otherworld, censorship aside. It's just cool to call it Otherworld. I guess. We have more transitions. They go to space. I mean, I could sum the whole damn thing up now. It's that basic, and yet the plot twists in between get a little, boring. Or unexpected. But then again, there's the very notorious and infamous problem that the series had with awkward cliffhangers, or just cliffhangers that were ridiculous. For example, that you were just going on non-sequiturs for the whole episode, while on the other important part of the storyline, the characters were charging up their super-powered Kamehamehas or whatever, but then it turns out that by the end of the episode, you hadn't gotten anywhere with that storyline, so you just had to wait until the next episode, which was usually next week, or next day in the case of Toonami. I think it was just, yeah, a daily thing. But regardless, it became a little aggravating to actually have to consistently go through that torture that it was. Now, of course, I was probably with a lot of my friends. I really liked Vegeta, but I also, in retrospect, really liked the character of Piccolo, even when he started having all these fusions and that was making him more powerful. But even with that, it became a very still interesting... he was probably one of my favorite characters, especially. I can't say I really had a lot of other favorite characters, considering most of them sucked balls. Especially the human characters that were so interesting and they had a lot of potential and everything. But when you start bringing in Vegeta, and then Vegeta actually being an anti-hero. But then we have Gohan. And then we have, of course, the guy from the future, Trunks, who actually, I'll admit, is another favorite character of mine, even though he can be a kind of an annoying wuss at times. But then, probably a lot of people have their favorites in one of the forms of Majin Buu at the end, but maybe I should try to focus this little rant on one of the bigger issues that comes up, and it's probably one of the bigger issues that comes up when any series tries this, in whatever fashion it does. And Dragon Ball Z did it in a certainly unique way, I suppose, but it reminds me actually of the fact that Akira Toriyama was connected with Chrono Trigger. Not so much Chrono Cross, but I'm pretty certain that the style does remind me, at least, if not pretty much confirm, that he was involved with some aspect of Chrono Trigger. Of course, Chrono Trigger's time travel is a much more common occurrence because they eventually get a friggin' spaceship. They can go through time. No more of this portal gate crap. Now, of course, in Dragon Ball Z, it was just this time machine, which Bulma probably could have done a lot earlier if she wasn't making googly eyes at every fucking guy that was in her path. It's kind of a division of her talents, because she's, yeah, mechanical genius, but she's also a hormonal teenager, or a hormonal young adult, or a bitchy adult, unfortunately. People would say her character kind of just went downhill, or stayed kind of average. Not very good, not very bad. But Vegeta as a character was always interesting because of the fact that he was that anti-hero presence, especially. That was probably what a lot of people liked. Hey, this guy's a bad guy. But hey, he's helping them. But he's not doing it because he wants to. And then eventually he starts admitting, yeah, I want to. But that was pretty much near the end of the series. He finally admitted that he wasn't just doing this because he was being a pompous asshole who just happened to be doing the right thing. He was actually kind of a, family guy, badass with a heart of gold, and that sort of thing. The badass mail clerk with a heart of gold, I believe was the quote, but I'm not sure about that. Anyway, I might go a little longer with this one, because YouTube doesn't care unless I go over 11 minutes, but I probably won't get there. But on to, I'd really say this is probably still the second favorite, and it's not just because of the fact that I grew up on it. It's a good advancement of Akira Toriyama's the storyline. That was kind of his plan, it would seem, from what I'm reading, but it's his story. He can do with it what he wants. And the advancement to this kind of sci-fi-esque series doesn't completely detract from the fact that they're still using ki energy and, you know, learning all these mystical abilities, especially with the instant transportation, which is, it's actually after the Frieza arc, I believe, but also after the Garlic Jr. arc, which I believe was actually one of my first exposures to it. Was it was a New Year's thing they were doing. It was called New Year's Evil, and that was what they were doing. They were showing the whole Garlic Jr. saga, and I thought, hey, let's watch this. It looks pretty cool. The animation looks nice and has a nice kind of storyline going on, so I did it. I watched it, but unfortunately I fell asleep, so I didn't, well, I missed some stuff, but I didn't miss much of it. Some admittance. Saw the end. Anyway. At least Dragon Ball Z didn't have as much filler as, say, other series that have suffered from filler syndrome. Particularly Naruto, but I won't get into it. That would be another rant ramble entirely, although I do not know how many parts that would be divided up into. Possibly just two, because of the fact that, well, it's only had those two manifestations, basically. But even if I was doing something like Bleach, I'd have to do at least two parts, because there have been significant points where there's been a crux in the series where things have turned very, very interestingly. So, I had to do that. I would have to do that anyway. But, anyway, to conclude with this one, yeah. Dragon Ball and Dragon Ball Z are Akira Toriyama goodness, even if Dragon Ball Z kind of would make the Dragon Ball fan a little, uncertain, perhaps. Or just thinking, wait a minute, what's Akira Toriyama come to at this point? But it doesn't matter. It's a good series. It has a plotline advancement that, while a bit sketchy, was possibly only a problem because of the fact that they were trying to make it seem like the manga. But, all that ranting aside, the next two are just going to be more general because I haven't, well, then again, I have watched Dragon Ball GT, and I think we still own about the first five movies, so I can actually make some genuine commentary on those. So, here's hoping I'll get them finished. And, see you later.